As a kid, I watched animated cartoons all of the time, like a lot of you did. But as I got older, my view of these cartoons changed. Instead of being absorbed in the cartoon, when I got older, I saw flaws, mistakes, purpose, and even messages hidden within these cartoons that I never picked up as a kid. And in fact, for the first time ever, I got bored of watching cartoons. Now, this isn't the kind of boredom where you can't find anything to do. This is creative boredom. Well, I guess that's what I'm gonna call it for this video. I was so tired of watching the fruits of someone else's hard work, someone else's ideas on the screen. I just wanted to create something that's mine. A story that I controlled so I could actually reach an outcome that I was satisfied with. That's probably the main reason that a lot of you are watching right now. You want to create something that you're satisfied with. You want to create something worthwhile that you can feel fulfilled while making and watching. You're creating the story that you would want to be told. So, you want to make your own animated series. Well, first of all, here's what you need. You're going to need a premise or a reason for your show to actually exist. This is the most important part of the show because it's actually why the audience will consider watching your show. Like in the show Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends, the show's premise is that these imaginary friends live in a foster home so they can be adopted by children. Anyway, you're gonna need characters. You're gonna need an episodic story of some sort. Like every single day, Matt comes from school and goes to the foster's home to see Blue and what he's up to. Usually it's something crazy and there's your episode. Since it's gonna be animated, you're gonna need some animation software and a drawing tablet. Probably gonna need some music, voices, if you want. So, is that it? The answer to that is actually no. A lot of you probably know that the animated series that you see on TV aren't made by one person. They're made by people. That is, teams of people. The cartoons that you watch are made by teams of people. People that work together and can get things done faster simply because there's more of them working with a similar goal in mind. So with that said, is it even possible to make an animated series on your own? And the answer to that is yes. The one thing you need over all the things I just told you previously is passion. Desire, the want, then the drive to make an animated series. It's a huge project. Think about it like this. In a lot of animation classes in college, university, or whatever, your final exam or final project will be to produce a short film. And you see these all over YouTube, and they're great, they're awesome, yeah. But a lot of times, these short films take months, they take weeks. And if you think about it, if you want to make an animated series, you're gonna have to make multiple short films posing as episodes to your animated series. So if you think about it, you're doing a lot more work than it actually sounds like. Studios make multiple of these short films and release them in a timely fashion, most likely when they're finished with the season or so. That's a lot of work. But it's not like you came here with nothing. A lot of you are watching this video already have some idea for your animated series. Some episodic story, perhaps, maybe a slice of life sort of cartoon. And maybe you thought of a couple characters, you thought of what it might look like in your head, and perhaps you even came here with some concept art. And that's all great. But my one tip that I'm gonna leave you guys with is if you want to make an animated series, you have to, please don't call me corny for this, make an animated series. I know it's gonna sound kind of crazy, but you really have to jump in and start doing it. And here's why. If you sit at your computer, you start animating, you start drawing your first character saying his first words on screen, you're gonna hit a couple roadblocks. And these are good roadblocks. You're gonna realize that you've only thought of maybe three characters, the main character and his friends. And you're gonna realize that you don't even know where this person lives. You don't know what the background looks like, you don't know what the lighting is gonna look like, you don't know what the tone of the scene is. So all that stuff you're forced to figure out because you just started on a whim. And that's good. Because it forces you to do all the other stuff that you need. It forces you to make the backgrounds, it forces you to perhaps compose some music or find some online, and that's really, really good. That is pushing you to make your series because it gives you a good reason why you're not finished with it. Because if the reason that you're not finished with your animated series is because you're composing music, that's a great reason. If the reason you're not making your animated series is because you don't have the gumption to make an animated series, that's not really a bad reason. More than it's just not a good thing. You want to have the drive to do what you want. That's in fact, that's what a lot of people want. It's what most people want. So my message to you in conclusion is to go and animate your animated series. Like, click away from this video. Go, like, get out of here. Do not watch until the end. Please watch until the end. The point is that you have to start. You have to mess up. You gotta look back and say, oh man, maybe my first scene wasn't that good. Maybe the storyboards weren't that good. You have to do that stuff. You have to start right now so you can get to the point where you look back and say, oh, maybe I can make that better because you've improved. You have to get to that point. So go and make your animated series. Go draw the first frame. Go download OpenToons and start animating for free. Go and start designing characters and worlds and drawing concept art for backgrounds and posting it on Twitter. Just do whatever. You gotta start. You gotta start right now. Cause then you'll get into the process. Your brain will be in it. You'll be thinking about so many things that you never even thought you would have to think about to make an animated series. Thank you guys so much for watching. I had a lot of fun making this video. I hope it was informative to you guys. I hope you guys kind of got a push to start your animated series if you were a little discouraged about it. I hope this helped you because there's not a lot of content about making an animated series on YouTube. And so I decided to, you know, insert my help here because I'm making my animated series Castle Dark, which you guys can check out in the playlist link above in the card. Thank you guys for watching once again. If you want to support the channel, you guys can go on my Twitter, my Discord, or my Patreon to support me. I really appreciate you guys leaving comments on this video. So if you have a comment, you want to say hey, you want to say thanks, you want to say whatever you want to say, just leave a comment. I read them all. Thank you guys so much. With that said, I'll see you guys next time. Peace.